Since the past few years, AMD has been holding pretty strong, and I was greedy for more cores and threads, and the 3000 series was the perfect excuse to upgrade my 6-year-old AMD 8350 setup. The 3900X and its many cores, many threads, lured me for the price point it was coming on. I've been using it for a few months now, and I assembled the system about 3 to 4 months back, but I was not able to get enough time till yet to make this put this video out. So here's a quick recap of how I assembled the many cores on the system on which I will be primarily rendering and occasionally gaming. Assembling many cores sounds so nerdy and geeky. And hey everyone, Mukul here. So I've tried to keep this video as much to the point as possible. If you have any kind of questions regarding configuring your system or assembling a PC, reach on to me in the comments below or on my Instagram, and I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. So except for the graphic card, which I later upgraded to 2070 Super, the video link of its review is in description. Everything else is the same to what I currently own and work on. I will also post their Amazon links in the description. You can buy from those to support the channel if you are feeling the supportive kind. I prefer placing the case and components on a wooden table and do wear some sort of footwear. It's actually almost impossible to get any kind of shock or current waves while assembling a system these days, but no one has ever got hurt by taking precautions. And this is how someone who upgrades their system after 6 years would look like. So my smart brain was at work, but it forgot to place the base screws first and then place the motherboard. So after a little pondering, I took the motherboard out, tightened the base screws first, and then screwed the motherboard. I had made sure to count how many screws were there, but now I kinda don't remember. And I also forgot to put the back panel plate in, and there you go. Do don'ts right in the beginning of the video. Make sure you align the back panel to the layout of the motherboard correctly before clipping it in. You should be an expert at this if you have ever played Legos in your life. So third time's a charm, and I can finally put the motherboard screws on and fix it to the case. Now once I'm done with that, I flip the case and I try to figure out the alignment of the power supply. And after a few attempts, I was able to successfully figure it out. So the CPU case was something which was a true evolution for me, coming from my very old CM692 case. And hence the concept of snapping SSDs right on the metal frame was something which was very new to me. I had to check online before I figured this out, and boy oh boy did I love doing this or what. Snapping these four rubber grips onto the case and putting the SSDs with its four screws felt so good. I mean, putting these screws felt so good, and it was not related to anyone screwing anyone here. This is how a true modular solution would look like, in my opinion. There were a couple of 3.5 inch hard drive trays and some RGB cables hiding behind the case. Because the PSU I am using is totally modular, I thought why not first hook the main power cable from the motherboard to it. This way I will also have to stop worrying about the thickest, damaged cable in the beginning itself. But sadly, at this very moment, I realized I shouldn't have put the PSU in its slot before doing this. So I took it out and plugged almost all the cables in, because pulling them out seemed easier than pushing cables in a blind spot within that vacant slot, which was too narrow for my hand. So I have put these two peripherals and SATA cables inside, and the standard 24-pin ATX. And then I put this 4+4 for the CPU. I hope you can read it. And then this 6+2 for the PCIe. After putting the PSU back in the same orientation, finally comes the moment of truth where I put the CPU in. Make sure you align these Ryzen processors' tiny arrow with the socket's tiny arrow. Both tiny arrows should align with each other. They must align or your processor dies, or just a few pins die, and when you fail to fix them, then the processor dies. After putting the CPU in and locking it firmly, I untied the rear exhaust fan cable and plugged it on the socket where it says chassis fan or CHA_fan. Check the manual of your motherboard and you will easily figure this out. By the way, I have replaced these fans, these case fans, with Be Quiet's fan later, and you can see its link in the card above or in the description below. Ah, the stock fan. I almost forgot I had one. I had replaced it with the Noctua U14S CPU fan recently, as I felt that with the stock cooler, especially in the summers here, the 3900X easily touched 90 degrees Celsius and even crossed it. So a replacement CPU fan was a must here. I was not sure if anyone would be interested in knowing how I install the Noctua U14S in this video, so let me know if you would be interested in that video too, and I will make and upload it. So pinning in the stock CPU cooler was extremely easy. There was a thermal paste already on the base of it, hence no extra paste was needed. But I had to make sure I take it out once to see how it was applied anyway, or was it just my OCD? Make sure to connect the CPU fan cable to the pins which says CPU fan on the motherboard. And by the way, I've also made an in-depth video on this motherboard. You can also find the link in the description below. Okay, now even after more than a decade, I see these cables still not having a fixed or more apt solution for it. Every time I see a new motherboard and these cables, I have to always check the manual and see which pins go where. Why is it so that these huge motherboard manufacturers haven't been able to single out one solution to this haywire of a pile of cables? Anyway, I checked the manual and I put them in. The orientation of these totally depends on your motherboard manufacturer. There are two slots for M.2 and NVMe drives on the board, and I made sure to buy one later, and it is peacefully resting under the heatsink slot. This was simple, just unscrew the heatsink nut, put the drive in, put the heatsink on top of it, and then screw the heatsink again. No biggie for the small thingy. Now this was my first build with any sort of RGB or addressable RGBs available on it. I simply hooked all the cables, the power cables of the RGBs, fans and lights to wherever they are supposed to go, to the PSU, and put the fan cable on the chassis underscore fan slot on the motherboard, and boy, they all just work thanks to the ultra simplistic RGB design of this Cooler Master case. And there goes the old GPU, which has not been replaced with 2070 Super. And whoosh whoosh, the cables go in and out the holes and get hidden behind the case. Put the hard drives in and plug a SATA cable on it and to the board, and a power cable which also looks like this and goes it in too. And tada, a clean looking assembly, because the other side is going to be hidden behind a non-transparent metal panel. And don't ask me when did I put the RAMs in, just make sure you put it in the right orientation, unclip its slots first and then push it inward. There have been some mods to the system, as I've already discussed here in the video. Check their links below in the description, and I have no idea how many more times I will repeat this. Hope the video was useful to you and your time. I mean, I can just hope, right? The world balances over hope that the earth won't ever fall. Did I make any sense? Do hit like and sub for more relevant content in the future. Check out my other videos. That's all for today. Mewbot out. Oops, I forgot to close the case in the video.